While addressing a press conference in Kampala after concluding a joint monitoring visit to Northern Uganda to inspect progress of a trust fund for victims, a fund that was created by Rome Statute to respond to harm resulting from crimes under jurisdiction of the ICC, members of a delegation of the Embassy of Ireland and Trust Fund for Victims have been impressed with the way this initiative has been able to rehabilitate and transform livelihoods of the people in Northern Uganda.
I do see a great development, great improvement. The projects are being developed in a very good way, and you can see how this has grown and how many more people are being beneficiaries of these efforts.
By implementing rehabilitation programs including medical treatment, trauma counseling and livelihood support in 22 districts of Northern Uganda, over 60,000 Ugandans have been rehabilitated from injuries sustained in the armed conflict, and over 350,000 people have had indirect benefits from the program.
I have already reached 60,000, more than 60,000 beneficiaries since 2008. For a variety of reparative measures.
According to Scott Battelle, the program's manager, the Trust Fund for Victims has rolled out several economic programs in Northern Uganda, especially in agriculture fields, vocational training, animal husbandry, among others, which have enormously been able to transform household incomes.
That is one of the kind of the core focus of our project, because those victims have no other opportunity to get treatment because they don't have the money to get it, or they don't have access to specialized surgeons and medical personnel to treat them for their injuries. And so we, through our projects, will address their physical injury needs through rehabilitation, through surgery and other medical treatment programs.
The Trust Fund for Victims has so far spent 12.5 million euros in the five ICC situation countries on the African continent since the program started in 2008. With only 2.7 to 3 million euros budget per year, the executive director of TFV and other officials believe the funding is still a drop in the ocean compared to the current need in all the ICC situation countries. They have called for more financial support from the Rome Statute member countries.
To get support for the trust fund, to build that support with Uganda, and the Ugandan government has been incredibly supportive and helpful. And your ambassador up in the Netherlands, although she's based in Brussels, has been incredibly helpful to us in organizing that. This is a big...
Officials have underscored a need to amplify stories of victims in suffering communities to remind and attract attention of policymakers for benefiting responses.
So our job, and we will do that with energy and commitment and passion, is to bring those stories back. Because no matter how successful this visit is, and it's been incredibly successful, we need to promote the work and we need to get that information back.
The Minister of Justice and Constitutional Affairs, Norbert Mao, who represented the government of Uganda at the presser, renewed government's commitment to respond to issues of war victims that are struggling with life after insurgencies by enacting laws that establish and support initiatives aimed at fostering justice to war victims. Mao also committed total support for the International Criminal Court.
There is a law that will support the work of the Victims Trust Fund. That is the Transitional Justice Bill. Because this is about moving from one stage in life to another.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.